I was asked this question the other day on Twitter. How do you get the Filmora effects to come in slowly instead of them hitting all of a sudden? Most of the effects in Filmora don't have a feature that lets you dial them in gradually, but there is a really simple trick that you can use to make that happen for all of them. Today I'll show you that with the blur effect. I have a piece of drone footage over a forest. Let's bring that down into the timeline, and if I drop a blur effect on top of it, you'll see it just suddenly gets blurry wherever that effect is placed. What you want to do is put the effect over the entire clip that you want your effect to be added to. Once you're done doing that, you want to bounce your footage. That just means we're going to export it all at a very high resolution and then bring it right back into Filmora. Now, let's lose that effect track and instead we'll place our bounced effect track directly on top of the first one and line them up exactly. Next, you'll just want to find the spot where you want the effect to start and slice through both tracks. Now you can delete the beginning of the blurred track and the ending of the original track and combine them together into one track. We do this so the blurred footage will pick up exactly where the original footage stopped, so it'll be one continuous shot. Now it might seem that we still have the same problem of the effect just starting suddenly, but what you want to do is go into transitions and find the dissolve transition. Bring that down and place it right between the two pieces of footage. This dissolve will slowly switch from the original footage into the blurred footage and make it seem like the effect is slowly being applied or dialed in. You can control the speed of that effect being applied by stretching the dissolve out to slow it down. Now you have footage that looks like that blur effect is gradual instead of a sudden drop. But here's another cool thing you can do if you're using the blur effect like I did. After I exported this footage, I realized that it reminded me of the Millennium Falcon jumping to light speed in Star Wars. So I increased the speed of the entire clip, split it right about where the blur began, and I put a zoom effect so that it really felt like the entire thing was picking up speed and surging forward. Here's the final effect. Tell me what you think down in the comments section below.